Hi everyone, Lewis here, and welcome to a new episode of Autism Talk. There's a side of me I want to talk about. As you all know, I'm autistic, my case is mild, also known as Asperger's Syndrome. Today I'll be talking about caring for severely autistic people at home. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell for alerts when I upload new content to the channel, especially those with disabilities similar to mine. In the last video, I talked about group homes and residential programs. Today, I will talk more about what I talked about at the end of the previous video. The topic for this was inspired by a mother who has an autistic son named James, who I also mentioned in the last video. She talks about how her son needs 24/7 care and also talked about how nurses who were hired once sadly abused him when she and her husband were away in Europe. I will post links to the channels to this person in the description below. She mentioned that the two men who she hired abused James by beating him and denying him freedom. Sometimes, like with group homes and residential programs, there will be people who abuse the patients they were hired to care for. I've seen her content on her channel on how she and James's other siblings helps take good care of him along with the nurses who are more kinder and have patience with him. In these situations, it's a lot of hard work, whether it's a young child who I've seen in videos before on YouTube who are nonverbal, or adults like James. Like James and others, they will have their good and bad days. In situations like seen in the videos I watched, it takes a lot of hard work and patience to help that person calm down and relax. When it comes to the subject, sometimes homes will be modified to suit the patient's needs, like for James or anyone else who's severely autistic and prone to self-injury. Padding around the walls in their rooms, as well as protective equipment, are used. Therapies like getting them into the pool calms them down and helps them relax. And lastly, even games, toys, movies, etc. are also used to keep them entertained. Thanks for watching, everyone. You can also follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And remember, it's time for adventure. Also, don't forget to stay home, stay safe, stay healthy, and only go out when it's necessary to.